Have you ever stepped into a physical store or checked out a shopping website online, only to buy more items than you need? Well, that's no coincidence. Businesses use a lot of tricks to get you to spend more money. But what exactly are those tricks, and how can you avoid these traps? You're in luck, as you're about to find out how you can take back control of your money and bank account. Let's dive right into it. Flexible return policies. What are some of the features you check every time you're shopping online? Most times, people will want to know if the company has a return policy and how many days this would be eligible. It makes you believe that you don't have to be stuck with a product you don't like or doesn't work as expected. Knowing that there's a return policy encourages you to buy, and these businesses know this. So they encourage you to return any item you're not satisfied with, which will make you likely to buy it in the first place. Then, they pair this with the trick of making the return window as long as possible, which you would pick between a bag with a 60-day return policy and a bag with no return policy at all. It's fair to say that a majority of people would go for the first option. Over time, you would become more attached to the product and won't feel the urgent need to return them. Creating urgency with countdowns. This is a very popular one. There's a good reason why you see a lot of online and offline stores with huge signs screaming at you to order immediately or you could miss out on an amazing deal. You also see words like "sale ends tomorrow" in bright red letters, and in a few minutes, you're thinking of checking it out to try your luck. These are all effective ways that stores trick you to spend more money. If you think a sweet deal is about to pass you by, the chances of buying will increase, and this is what these companies are taking advantage of. You would also see countdown timers on a lot of online stores, including Amazon, convincing you to buy at that moment or the price of the product will increase. Who wouldn't want to click buy when you think you're going to get something you like at half the original price? Big carts at shopping malls. It's no coincidence that most shopping malls will prefer that shoppers use huge carts other than carrying things around like little baskets. Most times, shoppers will go for big carts because they won't want to run out of a room while buying different items in the store. But this is actually a bad idea. A cart that is almost double the regular size will encourage you to buy a lot more than you need because no one really likes pushing an almost empty cart around. The psychology of this is that you believe you haven't bought enough when your cart seems almost empty, and this will make shoppers toss more items in. So here's what you should do every time you go shopping at your local grocery store or supermarket. Consider taking a smaller cart or basket instead, so it prevents you from overspending. Making it the talk of the town. Influencers will always be relevant in today's world, and businesses use them to keep people curious about their products, enough to buy. This is what is known as social proof in the marketing world. When a product becomes the rave of the town, you feel the temptation to check it out since that's what everyone around you is talking about. Mix this up with testimonials from experts, and these businesses have the impressive sales numbers they want. Automatic subscription services. Do you think it's cheaper to sign up for a monthly service or give in to the occasional splurge? Most people would argue that signing up for a product with a flat recurring rate would save you money and bring in more value. But that's actually wrong. At least researchers think so. They discovered that giving in to the occasional splurge is better. There's a high chance that you have subscriptions you meant to cancel, but you've just not gotten around to it yet. It's this laziness that businesses take advantage of when they introduce subscription boxes for their services. A lot of us don't want to go through the hassle of canceling a subscription, and that means we're getting the pockets of these companies nicely lined. It's time to check out your subscriptions and cancel the irrelevant ones. Encouraging you to buy bundles. Upselling is one of the oldest marketing tricks in the book. If you're a constant shopper at Amazon, then there's no doubt that you would see tons of items related to what you're buying and it pops up just before you click the checkout button. For example, if you wanted to buy a camera, you would get bundle offers of a camera case and a tripod stand. Of course, they would make you think that you're buying it for much less than you would if you got them separately. But is this really a deal? Only if you need them in the first place, using 99 cents on their prices. Have you ever seen a shirt that cost $9.99 and thought, wow, that's cheap, but didn't think the same way for a $10 shirt? That's no coincidence. So if you've ever wondered why most stores like to do this, then you're looking at a strategy known as charm pricing. After years of careful study, some researchers found that most people would think they're getting a cool deal at $9.99 because we see this as closer to $9 than to $10. This will, of course, increase your chances of buying because we're thinking it's a really good deal. This strategy has obviously been working for years, and that's why it's still very much in use today in most major stores around the world. The opposite of this is the prestige pricing, and it's common with high-end retailers. These stores use rounded pricing because most buyers link this to luxury and quality. Two for the price of one. Once again, getting you to buy something for free is a red flag most times. Still, everyone loves it when those signs flash, buy one and get one free. These businesses use deals like this to clear their inventory faster and make more money as well. How? Well, when you think about buying a $20 cap and a free one at a great price, you've actually spent the exact amount it would take you to buy two caps instead. Sometimes these businesses pick an item with a low profit margin for their discount offers. Order at one click. You would think that the only reason that websites have one-click ordering on pretty much everything is to make shopping as convenient as possible for you. No need to enter your credit card details for every transaction, it's just a click and debit routine. But there's a catch. Being able to order with just one click means that you don't have any chance to rethink your shopping decision. For huge shopping websites like Amazon, the advantage of this is that customers are less likely to abandon their carts. That means more money for them and, of course, less for you. But if you have to click a lot more or enter payment information for every purchase, there's a lesser chance of spending more than you should. Sometimes, when it's too easy, that's a major red flag. Websites and stores with bright colors. We can't deny that marketing involves a lot of psychology, and it's no coincidence that a lot of shopping malls have bright colors. Researchers discovered that these bright colors are connected to our moods and will encourage shoppers to buy more. The next time you step into your local store, check out where they have the brightest products, and don't be surprised to realize that they're usually up front. To save yourself from falling for this trick, start your shopping when you've walked a bit further into the store. Come in for a free sample. Did they just say free? Yep, that's right. But take a minute to ask yourself if anything in today's world is truly free. The truth is that there's a catch, and this trick will get you to actually spend more in their store. Most times, when stores get a little too generous with their products, there's an ulterior motive. Of course, no business owner would want to give out all their goods. They won't make any sales, right? Well, that's why they give out free samples, and there's a high chance you would buy at least one thing as a way of saying thank you. Take a minute to think back to every free sample you've ever gotten and would notice a pattern. Sometimes you would buy out of gratitude for the freebie, and at other times, it could be guilt at getting something for free from a small business. It's all a smooth trick, so next time someone tells you to come in for a free sample, think deeply about it first. Putting expensive items at eye level. This might sound mean, but all is fair in marketing, right? Stores place the expensive items at eye level, so that's the first thing you see when you're shopping. You can avoid this trick by checking out the products at the bottom aisle first before dropping any item in your shopping cart. Now you know the ways businesses trick us to spend more. And that's a wrap. Are there any tricks that you think should have made the list? Let us know in the comments. Did you like this video? Well, we're always posting amazing content like this, so don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out. Thanks for watching.